Well, hello everybody, and we're back for another trip. This time, myself and Moe are going to Switzerland. We were there 2 weeks ago, weren't we, Moe? 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 I'm speaking to you, Moe.
Leave me alone.
Oh, for God's sake, what's the matter, Moe?
Take a look around, look. Another bleeding week in a Volvo net.
Oh, yes, Moe, I know, I understand. But there's no point in being depressed, Moe. Moe?
Leave me alone. Oh, jeez, it's going to be a long week, Ned. I might have to get Billy Boy and go off and do a bit of tarmacking, you know.
Yes, Moe, but I mean, I leave it up to yourself, Moe. But I mean, we have to, when you're part-time, Moe, you have to get what you, take what you get, Moe, you know. Beggars can't be choosers.
Yeah, maybe you're a bleeding beggar, but I'm not. I get down my face with that camera and leave me, I'm depressed, leave me alone.
Okay, Moe, well, I'll talk to you later then.
Yeah, well.
There's the sea truck way out of Dublin port there now. That as far as I know, that goes to Haysham. A load of drop trailers on it. I think it only takes about 10 or 11 drivers. I'm not 100% sure.
I read of ancient free men, for Greece and Rome, who bravely stood, 300 men and free men. And there I prayed I yet might see how fetters went in twain, and Ireland long a province be, a nation once again. A nation once again, and Ireland long a province be, a nation once again. Each selfish plan with cruel passion ridding. But yet I hope someday to aid. Oh, can such hope be vain, when my dear country will be made a nation once again.
A nation once again. A nation once again.
We're about an hour and a half into our voyage. It's starting to get bright there now. We're about 140 kilometres, or maybe just slightly less, away from Strasbourg. And this is a seriously hilly part of France. You know, it's uphills, downhills. I have the retarder on there now, so I'm just. Just doing about it in about 90 k's there. Henry's a lot heavier than I am. I don't mean personally, I mean that he's a lot more weight on. I think he's gross 39 ton, and I'm literally, I think I'm only 27 or 28. So what's happening is when we're getting to the hills, I'm catching them and I'm having to step off the gas. There's another thing about France as well, and Belgium especially, and be careful how close you get, because it's easy just to follow too close to the unit behind or to the guy in front of you, and the police will fine you for doing that, especially in Belgium. So you want to hang back maybe 3 or 4 lengths of the lorry is all right, but don't be getting any closer than that, because you're looking for trouble, you know. In the service area, plenty of parking area, plenty of trucks parked there. Here's one coming out now. Well, I won't be too bad, I'll actually be way ahead of it, but it can be a bit of a nuisance. Belgian there. It can be a bit of a nuisance when they're coming out at the same time as you, and they're doing 90Ks and you're doing 85. And sometimes you just have to sit back and let them out, you know. I wouldn't think that Belgian there will be too long behind us. He's probably doing the 90Ks or in or about, so he should be catching up on us shortly. So that's it, Monday morning, July 15th, I think. And we're on our way to Strasbourg. Yes. Strasbourg. Mo's still not talking. Morning, Mo. Nope. Still no word out of him. He's just taking the ditch water now. Doesn't want to be in the Volvo at all. And he's maintaining radio silence, which is probably not a bad thing.
Hey, Ned, shut up, will you?
So just coming to a péage. There's a sign for a péage, 1 kilometer. It's the first one we've come to in France. We have these electronic... You can see them there among all the other stuff on the windscreen there, but there's a load of tags there on the windscreen. And hopefully one of them will work. So what we do is we go into the automatic telepass, they call it. And you have to go right up close to the barrier. And when you do that, it should go beep. Very narrow, these really are narrow. There goes Henry, and there goes my beep, and away we go. You used to have to, in olden times, you used to have to pay with your French road toll card, but nowadays it's a bit like the M50. You just zap it, so when it comes to even picking a ticket, you don't have to pick the ticket anymore. Just go through it. And it'll register it on the toll tag, you know, so. As daylight arrives, we just gonna tip along here. We've only done an hour and 40 minutes driving, so we'll go more or less our full 4.5 hours before we take a break. And then, you know, it should leave us fairly close then to where we have to do our customs. Okay, bye bye.
We're on the road to God knows where. again. Sure aren't we all Irish anyhow? Now is the time, set together now.
We're on the one road, share the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, and maybe the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? North and South men, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, swinging along, singing the soldier song.
Tinker, tailor, Epson, watch his son. Butcher, baker, shoulder in his gun. For Mitch man, a poor man, every man alive, all together just like old Lang Syne.
We're on the one road, sharing the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, and maybe the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? North and South and comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, swinging along, singing the soldier's song.
Dawn. From dissensions Ireland is reborn. Soon we'll all unite the Irish men, make our land a nation once again.
We're on the one road.
Good morning, Mo. Good morning, Mo. I say good morning, Mo. Oh, for God's sake, Mo, are you still in a mood? It's not my fault, Mo, we have to go in the Volvo. I just have to take what we get. Mo? Oh, don't be like that, Mo. Mo? Okay, suit yourself. Oh, you're such a moody git, Mo.
So we're back out onto the,
in 1.2 kilometres, keep left onto E60.
We're going Zurich direction, not Luzern or Bern. Going to keep left, as I said, Stationstrasse is the name of the street in this town we're going to. I've been there before, but it's not. It doesn't pick it up on the sat nav. But if you print it in, it'll show you where it is. So there is the signpost there for Chiasso, Bern, Zurich, and etc.
Keep left onto E60.
So we just wanna get into a proper lane. Chiasso is to the right, the Gotthard tunnel off to the right there. And we're heading for Zurich on the E25 motorway number 2. Ha ha.
Drive 47 kilometers on E60.
Are you happy, Mo? Are you happy, Mo?
Do I bleed? Look happy.
But not really.
Now there's your answer. Go away with you.
Oh, sorry, Mo. God, you are in bad form today.
Bad form every day in this show.
Yes, we know, Mo. Yes, we know.
So we're on our way down to the next delivery. It's about 47 kilometres from here, in the direction of the A1, which is Bern, Maganwell, and to the right is Basel, the way we come up. That's the road we come up.
34 kilometres on A1.
So we'll be on the motorway for another 34 k's, which is good, because the less we have to spend on the national road, the better. Less time, I mean. I'm not sure if these people are going to take it. It's 5:20, so it'll be about 5:10 when we get there. I'm not sure what time they finish. If they're there, I'm sure they'll take it off, and if they're not there or they're gone home, well then there's no big loss, because it's not due to tip until tomorrow anyway. But they're fairly decent. They're, you know, if they can, they'll take it off.
They take it off, all right, Ned, they'll take it off.
Yes, Mo, I hope they will, Mo.
Please take it off and I get in at them.
Yes, well, no, Mo, we mustn't upset the people. Very nice people in Switzerland, Mo.
Yeah, right, they're all nice. You get the pallet off.
Yes, Mo, don't be giving away trade secrets, Mo.
Yeah, right, trade secrets, eh? That's a good one, all right, then.
So, that's us now for the next half an hour or so. We'll see how we get on with it. It's just to give you an idea of what the sort of rural Swiss villages and towns look like from a right-hand drive truck. It's quite like Germany in the sense that it's very clean. You don't see any sign of any rubbish anywhere. Everything seems to be neat and well looked after and stuff. Well organized. There's a big railway track running just on the right side of us there. And I remember this stretch of road from the last time I was up here, that there must be a fairly rigorous enforcement of the speed limits, because the cars tend to, like, we're only doing a little bit of 44 Ks. There is diesel now.
At roundabout, 185.
So it's like 30 degrees centigrade here now at the moment. We have about 9 kilometers to go to Rogwell to get to this place. It'd be great if they took it off today, but it's not the end of the world if they don't, because it's not due to be tipped until tomorrow anyway. But the last time I was here, they took it for me. Now, I can't just remember whether I was here at 5 o'clock or after 5 o'clock. I just can't remember.
Continue 7.2 kilometers on Bernstrasse.
Bernstrasse is obviously Bern Street or Bern Road. Really nice countryside. You can see the way that the fields are manicured. Like, it's almost like somebody's out with a lawnmower cutting the grass in the fields. You know, very, very picturesque. I'm sure, you know, it's a different situation in the winter. I'm sure there'll be a lot of snow around here. But in the summertime, when the sun is shining, there's not a lot nicer places on the planet. You can tell by just looking at the houses and the design of the houses that you're not in Ireland or you're not in England, you know. But everything seems to be, as I said already, spotlessly clean, kept clean, you know, and organized, and you have lovely mountains and green grass, no more than we have at home, I suppose, but it's just really nice, just a really nice place. So we'll tip along here, so we have another 7.6 kilometers to go to get to this place, and hopefully we won't get held up in any traffic on the way in. And that they'll take the stuff, that they won't be gone home. But we'll see. Well, here we are in Rogwell on our second delivery of the day, and we didn't make it. We got here about, I'd say, maybe 10-15 minutes too late, and into the bargain, I got flashed by a camera in my haste to get here, which is a stupid thing to do, because now I'm going to have to pay the fine, whatever the fine is in Switzerland, for speeding. So the moral of the story is, if it says 50 kilometers an hour, it's 50 kilometers an hour, and if that means that the place is closed when you get there, that's the way it works. You have to obey the laws of the land, and now I have to wait until tomorrow morning to tip it. It's only 3 or 4 pallets. That's not the end of the world, as I said already. It would be nice to get it done this evening, you know, and get away from here. Now I'm staying here now. If we can give you a look around where exactly I am. I'm actually just at Rogwell train station. It looks like something out of the Wild West. You have it's like a commercial train station, and also there's a passenger platform up there. It's a really nice little place. It's in the middle of nowhere, basically. And this is where I shall stop now for the next 15-16 hours. There's no toilet. There's no restaurant.
There's no shower, there's no nothing. It's just a piece of tarmac, and that's where I must stay. Now, I could go and drive back, you know, up the road and park in the service area, you know, but what's the point, you know? I just hope that I don't have anything urgent to do between now and tomorrow morning. So that's it. Here I stay. It's now 20 to 6 local time, 20 to 5. So I'll be here for about 16 hours. There's no real point in me getting up at 7 o'clock in the morning to go in there and tip and start my day at 7 o'clock, because that means at 10 o'clock tomorrow night then I have to stop. So I'll toddle on in about 9 or half 9. There's a train going by there now. It's a lot of goods trains and stuff are going past here. So he said it's okay to park here, but I'm assuming that that's going to be the case, you know. Just up on the bridge there, that bridge there is the road you have to come across, and they're doing some kind of tarmacking on it, and they had the road closed for us coming down this way, but I ignored it. I said no way, there's no way I'm getting diverted up around the village. I knew at that stage where I needed to be, so I just went around it and carried on, you know, because there was no other way to get down here apart from that way. So that was it. So my camera's broken as well. The bracket off the camera broke. But it's only cheap anyway. You can see it there. Look, it's all broken off. So I'll have to get that replaced or get it fixed or do something with it, because it's not really much use the way it is now. I'll get some super glue maybe. This is the other. It's the other section of it that broke off. That's supposed to sit there like that. Something like that. And the camera sits on it then. So. All in, not a wonderfully successful day, but you get days like this, and the most important thing is not to let it get you, you know, because nobody died, you know. That's the most important thing. It's just another day. I'm not late for the delivery, because the delivery was down for tomorrow morning anyway. And we're back on the road again. Now Tuesday morning we did our delivery in Rogwell. Just 3 pallets, 1 pallet of frozen and 2 pallets of ambient. So we just got a call from the office that we're loading in Liège in Belgium, which is a long way from here. It's basically back down to Basel, across the border into France, up through France into Luxembourg, and from Luxembourg back into Belgium again. And loading there tonight, apparently. It'll take us more or less all of our car to get up as far as there. And but we loaded Tuesday night, being Friday morning at the latest, you know. So we're now 28 kilometers from Basel, which is the border, 67 kilometers from Mulhouse, which is in France. So what we have to do is, when we go to the border on the way back out and we're empty, you follow the signs for Leer, L-E-E-R. That's obviously means empty or whatever. And what you have to do is, you pull up at the security check, you fill in the mileage that you're leaving the country with, and they subtract that from the mileage that you came in to the country with, and then it gives them how many miles you've done in Switzerland, and then you pay for that. That's simple as that. You have to sign the ticket and give it in to them. It's very important you don't lose that ticket, because it's your only record of the miles you've done, and you need to put it somewhere very safe, because if you don't and you lose it, it causes all sorts of grief and problems. I have 2 sort of triangle shaped pieces of timber that were used against the closed split door. And I took them out this morning when I took the pallets out and lifted the door, but your man wouldn't let me leave them there, so they're sitting in the back of the fridge now. They make a good bit of firewood, all right, but they're not really going to take any much space. I might just throw them in on top of the pallets. If I can't get rid of them in Liège up here, I will just throw them on top of the pallets, and maybe somebody could make use of them at home, maybe, or something like that. But the traffic there on the far side, they're doing something with the bridge, and it's down to one lane, but it doesn't take a whole lot, you know. Even in the middle of the day, it doesn't take much for traffic to build up, you know. These are only 2 lane roads, the same as in France. So
aussi avec Favel et Neto. Ils vont venir vous voir sur la tournée d'été Énergie Extravagance Tour by Sam. Les plus grands DJ, vos stars préférés sur la plage et en disque. On va se régaler, ça démarre vendredi au High Club à Nice avec DJ DMB et Axel Tony. Et vous avez les dates de la tournée sur energie.fr.
So we've just crossed the French-Luxembourg border, and we've landed into this. And according to the board up there, we've got 5 kilometres of it, which is a real pain in the ass. 4:30 in the evening here, but I never saw anything like this now before. Just 5 kilometres of standing traffic, and it's a nightmare. It's going to be a nightmare now to get through this. We just happened to hit it at the wrong time, I suppose. Bloody Luxembourg. Bloody hell. What do you think of that, Mo? What do you think of the traffic, Mo? Oh, remaining silent, are we? Okay.
Slowly working our way up through Luxembourg, and we're trying to get into Belgium here, and I'll tell you, we've after losing at least 50 minutes in traffic there. They had the whole road closed down to one lane just to do a little bit of fixing on a bit of barrier that had nothing got to do with the road at all. But they should have, they could have, and they should have done it at night time. It got to cause an absolute mayhem. It's not only just rush hour in Luxembourg, but they also have these feckin' roadworks in the middle of the city, which is absolutely and totally nonsensical. And there was lorries abandoned and the hard shoulder all over the place. In other words, these are guys who were tipping along and saying, right, I have enough driving time to get me to X place. And then they ran out of hours because they were sitting on the, sitting in traffic like morons, because these other morons were deciding that they wanted to fix a barrier, and they just closed a, there's only a two lane road, and they closed one lane, and they were sitting, standing around rooting at this barrier when it was way in off the road. They could have done it at any stage. So it's, I don't know, the police really, you know, want to get a grip of themselves really in Luxembourg, you know, when they allow that kind of stuff, especially this time of the year, holiday season. You know, the barrier was dented, it wasn't going to make any difference. It wasn't, there's no jagged edges sticking out of it. And it could have been left, or it could have been done at night time when the roads are quiet, but no, they decided to do it in the middle of the day. Absolute morons now is the only way you could describe them. So we have 158 kilometres to go. We should be literally only 100 kilometres, should be a 50k ahead of them ourselves, but because of them morons back there now, we're going to be delayed. 1 hour and 5 minutes driving time, which realistically speaking, we've only done about 25 minutes, because the rest of the time we've been sitting doing an inch at a time in traffic. But it still goes down as you know, you're driving, you know, even if you're only inching. So, well pissed off with that. And I hope that that's bloody well the end of it now, because I couldn't take any more of it now today. That's been a really just sickener now that has, you know. So into Belgium now, and hopefully that'll be the end of our traffic. We'll catch up the road a little bit. So this is the Belgian border. So it used to be the old customs checkpoint here. This is literally crossing over now into... Okay, we're in on Belgian soil now. Nice evening here too. And this is where Habe, the truck stop, is number 29. We're at junction 23, but at junction 29 is Habe. That's the big truck stop where we stay on the way down the road. Right, so that's us loaded in Liège and heading up the road. We're going in the direction of Calais, but we're not going to get there tonight because we haven't enough hours left. We've been on the road since about 10:30 this morning, so we have 8 hours, about 8.5 hours driving done. And so we'll do another hour and a half, and that'll be our fun 10 hours driving done for today. And you can, that's the maximum you can do twice a week. So we'll find somewhere secure, a service area, the far side of Brussels or somewhere around Ghent, hopefully, and we park up there. What it means is that when we get up in the morning, we don't have to sit in traffic, you know, and waste hours, because we're going to need every single minute. We're going to need every single minute of what we have tomorrow, and we can't afford to be messing around. Bloody sat-nav has gone off again. That's a bloody disaster, Bjork. It's
driving in a field there now. Look, it doesn't have a clue where
Please
it is.
Please try to highlight a route.
It's on the E40, which is the red road, and it thinks it's in the middle of a field. Look, it's in the middle of a field. Look, that's how bad, look, that's how disastrously bad that thing is. Look, it's way over the fields. Look, way over the fields it is now. I'm honest to God, like, you know, for something that cost over
Please try to highlight a route. We're calculating. For something that cost over 300 quid,
to be doing that is not acceptable.
Please try to highlight a route. We're calculating.
It hasn't got a clue where it is. It hasn't got an absolute bog's notion where it is. I haven't moved off the E40, which is the red road you can see on the top left.
Please try to highlight a route.
And it just
We're calculating.
Keeps spouting out the same crap. It just, I don't know whether it's got some kind of dementia problem or whether the software is just breaking down on it, but it's absolutely...
Please try to highlight a route. We're calculating.
Like, if you didn't know where you were going, you'd be panicking looking at that because they're thinking, look, it's driving across fields there. Completely ridiculous.
Please try to highlight a route.
It's going to switch it off now because that'll only do my head in, you know. Yeah, so it's time for a change with that. I mean, that's disgusting, really, because it's only about 2 years old, that thing, and it shouldn't be doing that. And I don't know whether it's the same. There was a software issue with it before, and I sent it back to Garmin, and they fixed it and sent it back, but it's something wrong with that again, because it can't be doing that, you know what I mean? I mean, I'm driving on E40, you can see it's a big, wide, open road, and the bloody sat-nav is in the field driving along beside me, you know? Anyway, that's the story for the moment, so we'll catch up with you later on, but for now, we've an hour and a half left, and you can see even now that the, even though it's only like, it's 9 o'clock here, and the daylight's starting to fade a little bit. I suppose it's just a sign that we're coming into autumn, you know? I knew you'd like that. Bye.
So this is our last leg of the French side of it. Just arriving into Calais now. Don't have any idea what the situation regarding waiting, queuing, and etc. etc. will be. There's quite a lot of stuff coming off the boat, and there's probably quite a lot of stuff waiting to get on it, so we'll just have to go down, go through the scanner, go through the routine, and just basically go with the flow in here, because there's no way you can get around it. There's no shortcut you can take, or you can't go, you know. You have to just go through the scanner, queue up, they give you a ticket, and whatever ticket they give you, that's your boat. And if it's 2 hour wait, it's a 2 hour wait. And that's just the way the cookie crumbles here. You know, there's nothing you can do. It's fairly well organized regarding sort of queuing systems. Everyone has to go through it. Everyone has to take their turn. So there's not a big stress level involved in sitting there watching other people getting going miles ahead of you. This is a disaster here now. I'm just looking at it here now. Massive queue to get in here, and this is just to get in through the scanner. You can see all the lorries backed up there now. We could be here for 2 or 3 hours at this rate. This is not good. This is not good. So we're just about to load onto this old tub here in Calais. Calais 9 we're going on. And we're going on the bottom deck. Cars, I'd say most of them are going on the top deck. You see them queuing up there on the right hand side, just over the rails. It's a very interesting looking Volkswagen. Guarantee it's running a lot better than mine anyway.
Okay.
Thank you.
Is it off?
It's off anyway.
It's off.
Yes. Okay. Oh, she wanted me to switch off the fridge, but I told her it's off already. No point in switching it off if it's already off. Oh, Mo, get up, you lazy git.
Bleeding hell now, but you want to try your driving, will ya? Bloody hell, that's knocking me over and me blanging me bleeding head. Jeez, Ned, tonight will you cop on to yourself, will ya?
Mo, you're just in very bad form, you know. You, there's nothing will please you this week, Mo.
Yeah, you're bleeding right there, Ned.
So, into the mouth of the ferry, and then wait for the directions of the...
Okay, he wants to bring me over. Ah, he's gonna ferry me over. The fucking scumbag. bury me over on the far side.
So we're right on the left lane here, so we're going to be slow getting off. We're one of the last getting off this old thing because we're right over against the far left wall of the ferry, which means that everybody else will be off before us. We're the last line to get off. And it's very, very slow here. Let's see what's happening. Starting to move now. And not before time, let me tell you. It's going to bring us out into Dover Port. And another queue then for the passport or for the, I don't know what you call it, the exit. You can be lucky if you get on the boat, you know, relatively quickly. You can be off relatively quickly, but we'll be the last of the summer wine now coming off of this because there's only about three lorries behind me, and otherwise it's us, we're the last. So, gonna bite. Looks like a nice sunny day here in Dover. No doubt there's a ball of stuff waiting to get back on. Starting to load it already, you see. And we're literally just coming off. There's all the freight getting ready to get back on. Going to be a delay here, like, you know what I mean? No matter what way we look at it. There's no point in panicking. Because we get off when we get off.